Hello, I'm Rodrigo Castillo. I'm a product manager on the Microsoft Identity product group. I will show you how to create custom reports with the data that you have on Microsoft Entra ID Governance using Azure Data Explorer, exporting the data from Microsoft Entra ID to Azure Data Explorer cluster, and using KQL and Azure Data Explorer dashboards to create a custom view of the data. In this example, I will create a dashboard for managers to give them visibility of the access package assignments of their direct reports.
I will use Microsoft Graph to get the information that I need for my dashboard. I want to show you using Graph Explorer the two endpoints that I need to query. The first one is the assignments. Here I have all the information about the assignment, the target that in this case is the user that has the assignment, and the access package name. The other endpoint that I need to query is the users. Here I have all the information about the user and also the manager of the user. There are different ways to export the data here and upload it into Azure Data Explorer. One of the options is just to copy the output that we have here and save it to a file. And the other one is using one of the code snippets that we have here for PowerShell or for Python. I will use the code snippet that we have for PowerShell. So using PowerShell, I will get the information about the user and save it into a text file. And I will do the same for the assignment endpoint. Now that I have the two files that I need to upload, I will go to Azure Data Explorer. Here, I want to highlight a couple of things. I already have one cluster that is a free cluster in a database. Here you can find the cluster URI. We will use this information later for the dashboard. I will start uploading the data, going to query, and specifying that I need to get data. As my database is empty, I will create a new table with this information. I will use a local file. This will be the user table. It will detect all the columns that I have and will create the table and upload the information to the table. I will do the same for the assignments. I will click Get Data again, choose Local File, and I will create one assignments table. I will choose the other file that I have for assignments. And now I have the two tables that I need and all the data there. The next step is to create a dashboard. I will create a new dashboard and I will put a name that my direct reports. The first thing that I need to do in the dashboard is to create a data source. Here I will specify a name and I will need the cluster URI that I mentioned before. Once I specified the cluster URI, it will detect the database that I already created, and I will be ready to start doing queries and adding tables and charts to my dashboard. The first table that I will add is all the information about the direct reports of the user that is logged. Here I will use a query that I already have. And with this query, I'm getting the object ID of the user that is logged and is searching for all the users that had that user as a manager. Here I can see all the direct reports of my current user. I need to apply changes. And now I have the first table for my dashboard. The other thing that I will do is to create a parameter. I want to create a parameter in order to choose some specific users and see the assignments that those users has. The parameter will be direct reports The variable name is important because I will use this value in my queries. I will use the same query that I used to create my table, and I will need to specify the value column, that is the object ID, and the label column that I will use the display name. I need to specify a default value. I will say that select the first value of the query, and it's done. I already have my parameter. Now I can see all the direct reports and I can choose some of them. Now I will create another title. Here I will show the assignments of the users that I am selecting. For this, I have another query. With this query, I'm joining the two tables that I created, and I'm using the parameter to just show the user that I am selecting. I can see the preview here. And as you can see, if I change the users that I am selecting here, the data will be different. I will apply the changes. And now I can see that information dynamically. I can choose all the users to see all the assignments of my direct reports, or I can specify just one of them. Now I will add a chart to my dashboard. Here I will use a very similar query than the one that I just created, but with the difference that I am using a summarize in order to group the information by access package name. Here I can see an overview of the assignments that my direct reports are using. And again, this is dynamical. If I change the information that I have here, the information on this table will change. Now I will change this title to be a chart. I will select a pie chart. Now I just add a chart in order to see the most common assignments on my direct reports.
Please check our documentation for more information, and thank you for watching.